HEMA's biggest arch rival is RLD Supremo Ajit Singh's son and sitting MP Jayant Chaudhary. 35-year-old Jayant Chaudhary is a member of the Rashtriya Lok Dal Party. As the sitting MP, his strength is the caste backing from Mathura. Contesting from Mathura on a Rashtriya Lok Dal seat, Jayant comes from a family of politicians. Jayant Chaudhary is the grandson of former Prime Minister Charan Singh and son of the veteran leader Ajit Singh. Known as the son of the soil and a grassroots level worker, he has hardcore supporters in Mathura. Jayant Chaudhary has been extensively campaigning in Mathura and seven other constituencies where RLD candidates are fighting elections. Talking about his plans for Mathura, Jayant says he wants it to be a part of National Capital Region so that people have greater access to developmental infrastructure.
जनता के हित में सरकार फैसला ले और कैबिनेट ने आप हित में फैसला किया और परिणाम ये होगा कि आने वाले सालों में
The vote bank in Uttar Pradesh is heavily influenced by caste and with a Yadav and Jat majority, Jayant is sure of sealing victory once again. RLD was once a BJP ally, but with time, now RLD is an alliance with the Congress. Banking on promises of development, Jayant believes that Hema Malini, an outsider in Mathura, stands no chance against him. Ironically, during the last Lok Sabha elections, Hema was on his side as RLD's star campaigner. This time, he has locked horns with her, but he is confident the people of Mathura will show him their love. News 9 caught up with a young and dynamic leader.
I'm in conversation with Jayant Chaudhary, who is the incumbent MP from Mathura constituency. Jayant ji, what developments have you done here that you're proud of?
Well, primarily, you know, you as an MP, it's not as if you can develop the entire region and every village. Your primary role is policy making and raising pertinent issues in parliament. And it, with regards to my parliamentary work, I think I've tried earnestly to raise issues, whether it's Yamuna pollution, land acquisition. This is a very district and region that saw a lot of violence, violent protests. Farmers were agitating and at large scale acquisitions were undertaken by the state government. So I'm happy to say that at least there's a land acquisition law today that is more equitable, balanced. And I had introduced a private member's bill on land acquisition. I was the only MP to have done so in Lok Sabha, after which the government proposal came through. Now the law is such that all the land that was due to be acquired in Mathura has been released and farmers will get the benefit of that. In terms of MP lads, I've utilized all my funds and in fact 19 crores were allotted to me. I've been able to give 21.5 crore worth works proposals. That's only because I did free and fair tendering and competitive bidding took place.
Why did you leave BJP alliance and join Congress in the last assembly elections?
See, we were in an alliance. And if you look at the political history of the country, there is no party that has not entered into alliance with one party or the other. We are in a niche, it's a small party, but we are very focused on our issues. When we were in the opposition, land acquisition issue was a major issue for us. I tried to frame the policy in parliament as an independent MP, as part of opposition. When we became part of the government, we put our efforts in getting the government to pass the bill. So it was an issue-based coalition that we entered into the UPA, and I think they've fulfilled their commitments, whether it's one rank, one pension, land acquisition, Jat reservation, several issues that came up during our tenure.
How does it feel to stand against someone who campaigned for you once?
She came once in a meeting in Mart. Now she says that because we've changed alliances, she's competing against me. 5 years ago, I was a good candidate. So it's politics, you know. I mean, BJP is aligned with Mayawati. Lalji Tandon used to call Mayawati his Behna. Now Mayawati is a secular person. Mulayam Singh ji, he meets Singhal ji for 2 hours, 3 hours. But he is also trying to eye those votes. It's politics. People change lives.
Do you think film stars can be taken seriously as politicians in North?
Well, you know, in humor, I'll say that some films are flops and some films are hits. But in real life, if you look at it, you have to work very hard, you have to be with the people, you have to have a clear sense of issues. You know, and she's already a Rajya Sabha MP. If she was so sincere about Mathura, then she would have shown her activism in Parliament. What will she do now? She's already an MP. If she wants to raise these issues, she already has a platform. She doesn't need to come to Lok Sabha. So where has she utilized her funds? How credibly has she raised issues that are pertinent to the region? Voters should look at that and then judge her commitment.
So what do you think about the so-called Modi wave? Do you think it is there?
10 years for UPA, so there's bound to be some level of anti-incumbency. But it's all a question of how we structure the campaign, how we take the issues to the people, you know, that the achievements of the last 10 years. It's up to the UPA to really sell that. And one thing I would say that this election is a first in the sense that this campaign is not about issues. It's about faces. Whether it's a film star or it's Narendra Modi, it's Modi Sarkar, it's no longer BJP or issues or, you know, there's no second run leadership. There's no one in BJP today who can even question Narendra Modi. So there's a certain arrogance, there's a certain, that's a scary aspect of the campaign. That, you know, unlike the West, you're trying to ape American model of presidential elections. But there you have debates based on issues. Here you just have these large scale shows that are being put up for the public.
A graduate with an MSc degree from London School of Economics, Jayant has emerged as the new breed of young, dynamic and well-educated third generation of politicians. He may be banking on past glory, but the people of Mathura are skeptical about voting him to power once again.
हमारी जमुना जी का है, जमुना प्रदूषण का चल रहा है, पर जमुना जी में बहुत तकलीफ हो रही है, बाहर से श्रद्धालु आते हैं, बड़े परेशान होके जाते हैं। तो जैन चौधरी एक ऐसा कैंडिडेट है जिसको जिताएंगे तो कर सकता है कुछ।
तो आपको लगता है कि जैन चौधरी?
हाँ, जैन चौधरी जीतेगा।
जैन चौधरी काफी शिक्षित एजुकेटेड युवा शक्ति हैं और उन्होंने लोकसभा में संसद में मथुरा के विकास के मुद्दे को, यमुना प्रदूषण के मुद्दे को काफी अच्छे तरीके से उठाया है, लेकिन टाइम के अभाव की वजह से नहीं कर पाए, लेकिन इस बार हमको उम्मीद है वो पूरा करेंगे और निश्चित विजयश्री उनको ही मिलेगी। जाट वोट किसानों के तैसी है, मथुरा के विकास के लिए जयंत चौधरी, और हमको पूरी उम्मीद है लाखों वोटों से जयंत चौधरी ही जीतेंगे।
While BJP and RLD are fielding very promising candidates, the newbie in Indian politics, Aam Aadmi Party, is trying to clean Mathura with its broom. AAP is fielding businessman and a new entrant in politics, Anuj Garg, in battlefield Mathura. 47-year-old Anuj Garg might be making a debut in politics with the 16th Lok Sabha elections, but he is not a new face in the by-lanes of Mathura. A businessman by profession, Anuj has done charity work for 14 years through various charitable organizations. With a promise of providing better governance, good employment opportunities and a corruption-free conductive atmosphere, the AAP leader hopes to sweep the people of Mathura off their feet. News 9 caught up with Anuj Garg.
I'm here in conversation with Anuj Garg, the Aam Aadmi Party candidate from Mathura. Sir, how confident are you of the win?
I am 100% confident we will win. There is no scope of defeat because I am getting a very good favor from all part of the life, from rural, urban and city as well.
So you will be contesting against the biggies of Mathura constituency. So what do you think, what is the different strategy that is applied by you?
I don't think they are the biggies. They may be the glamorous biggies, they may be the political biggies, but I think Aam Aadmi is the biggest one among all, and they will give me the chance to win.
If elected, what are the three issues that you will give priority to?
Basically, I think in human life, few are the fundamental rights of Aam Aadmi, like water, electricity, house, health and education. These are the five major issues, fundamental rights of a human, any human beings. And my main focus is, will start from the water. I think every Aam Aadmi should get the minimum water, minimum electricity, minimum education. Here the position is very is entirely worst situation in Mathura. It's only 150 kilometers from the capital of India, and situation is there is no water, there is no electricity, poor roads condition, poor drainage conditions, poor education system, as well poor health system. So my priorities will be to start development from the grassroots level of the villages to at least provide them the water, drinking water, health issues, hospitals, education, schools, and electricity.
Arvind Kejriwal resigned from the post of chief minister after 49 days. Do you think you will continue the tenure, like you will finish the tenure of your, if elected as an MP?
I will not only complete my tenure, I will complete my whole life for this political work for Mathura.
Thank you, sir. Good luck.
The AAP leader is well educated with an MSc degree and has a strong will to make his presence felt in Mathura. His presence here in the Krishna Janmabhoomi is especially intimidating, as other political biggies fear the AAP performance in Delhi. If the newbie is not successful in reaching the winning number, he may very well play the spoiled sport. Like the rest of the nation, Mathura too is abuzz with promises of development and better opportunities as the elections close in. Major political parties are doing their best until the last minute to bag more and more votes. But who will play the flute in Kanha's Mathura is totally up to the people to decide.
Mathura constituency will be closely watched. So will it be Hema Malini from BJP riding high on the Modi wave? Or will it be Jayant Chaudhary from RLD in alliance with Congress, who is banking on the Jat vote? Or will it be Aam Aadmi Party's Anuj Garg or BSP's Yogesh Trivedi, who is banking on both Dalit and Brahmin votes? We get you all that as and when it happens. For now, with my colleague Sanjay Dixit and cameraman Ajay, this is Sharon Elizabeth signing off for News 9 from Mathura.